today. From Las Vegas, Nevada. This is Madden Football on EA Sports. Raiders taking on Kirk Cousins and the Minnesota Vikings.
NFL football has come to Southern Nevada as we are in the menacing new Allegiant Stadium here in Las Vegas. The atmosphere here, electric. No matter the venue, the home folks love their silver and black. They are fired up as their Raiders get set to face off with the Minnesota Vikings. Stadium. On the return, Tyron Johnson. And able to get this out to the 25. So here comes the Raider offense now onto the field. They'll be led out by a man who rewrote Brett Favre's passing records at Southern Miss. It's Nick Mullins.
And what I enjoyed watching this week when we had a chance to watch them at practice, the easy camaraderie that he has with his offense.
A lot of respect.
A lot of respect, and frankly, I thought it spilled over to the defense. All the defensive guys were coming over and teasing and joking with him. You can tell they respect the heck out of him and really want to play well for him.
They go play action here on first down. Well, he's going to take a shot right away. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
So the incompletion, and now it's second and 10, again from the 25-yard line. Looking to throw. Got a man open. It's Darren Waller. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. They'll look to throw here. Looking again for Waller, and he's got him again. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. Well, that's always a good place to throw it just because he's one of the biggest targets not only on this team but in the National Football League.
And you and I both know the quarterbacks love these large body tight ends, and why not? Nowadays, they're really wide receivers who are just taller and have a little bit more weight. These guys catch the football, make big plays downfield. In the old days, we wanted them to block. Now coaches want them to catch the football first. Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
From Viking territory now, they'll come up first and 10 at the 49-yard line. And despite the good footwork, he'll be hit and dropped shy of the 45. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
I think if we put together a job description for a middle linebacker, we would start with being able to hold down things in the middle of the line of scrimmage and be able to take on blockers. But how about the guys who can go sideline to sideline and make plays?
Love a guy that can do that. We saw a perfect example of it right there. On second down, Walter. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
An extra defender in the secondary for the Vikings here on third down. He'll look to throw. He gets this to Devontae Adams. And he is going to have the Raiders' first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Nice job keeping that opening drive alive, and they're in plus territory, that part of the field where you really want to convert on third down. They did.
Big time pickup for them, and now I think the aggressive play callers think to themselves, this part of the field, I take my shot at the end zone, because the closer you get to the end zone, the field gets condensed. Makes it a lot tougher to run those routes. You still got a chance to actually run past people right now. Take your shot at the end zone early in the down and distance count.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Catch is made by Hunter Renfrow. That catch good for only a couple.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
Here's second and eight. Over the middle, that's caught by Adams. This first drive, they're being aggressive, slinging it around.
Really confident, too, because they're not trying to fool them with running plays, throwing it, and they're being very successful right now.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one. Well, he did everything but get him in the end zone there, but now they're set up. Golden opportunity, strong opening drive, and they're knocking on the door.
And the way that they did it, now look where they are on the field, all right? This is naturally set up for a running play, isn't it? But with his ability to throw the football, his accuracy on this drive, you might want to think about a pass play in this situation.
Interesting. Time to find out. First and goal at the one. Back to throw again. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
Another shot from the one on second and goal. They'll try to run this one in. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Punching it in from a yard away. And the Raiders drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. Well, nothing fancy there, Charles. You had three tight ends on the field. They were going to run the football. The defense knew it, but the defense couldn't stop them.
And I haven't met an offensive line yet that doesn't get more satisfaction out of running the football into the end zone than pass protecting. They had determination on their side, and they got it done.
Now for the extra point, Daniel Carlson. And that makes it 7-0 Vegas. That one in the books as a 12-play drive, and it ends with a 1-yard touchdown run. The touchdown. Ready to kick it away is Carlson. Taken in at the three. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. Minnesota's offense and QB Kirk Cousins set to go here.
And one nice thing you can always say about Kirk Cousins is that he's consistent. Always puts up nice numbers each and every year. If there is a downside to his game, it's been the lack of playoff success. All in all, though, formidable starting quarterback at a time in the league where it's tough to find your franchise guy.
Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 at their own 27. Cook with a run on first down, but he'll only manage a couple there before he's taken down.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Play fake. Cousins. That is caught by Thielen. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A big play that time through the air. 32 yards. After one, 7-0, EA Sports. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Cousins now. Open man once again, it's Thielen. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. Seems as if the passing attack's starting to heat up a little bit here in the second quarter.
You can sense and you can see the momentum because now they're reading their patterns downfield, they're understanding the coverages, and they're finding the open holes in the defense.
A first down throw for Cousins. He'll dump this off to Cook. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. They'll wind up getting 7 on the play, and that'll make it a second down. To throw, Cousins. And incomplete.
Good coverage on the outside, and I think that's where he wanted to check that down to. But once he saw the danger over there, he just threw that one over everyone's head. Smart play.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3. They'll throw again. Cousins. And that is incomplete. But the pressure there on 3rd down, forcing the errant pass. 4th down coming up.
Well, it's been a tough go for him. These guys have been driving down the field. But defensively, once they got their backs to the goal line, turned up the pressure, that's going to lead to a 4th down. Well played.
Now the Vikings. Vikings will send out the special teams crew here for a field goal try. The kick by Joseph is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So, yes, it's only three, but at least they're able to answer back after giving up the touchdown to start the game.
Yeah, I like the observation there because getting some points on the board, very positive for them. Feel a little bit better about things because if you don't score, you potentially have opened the door for them to score again, and then you're down 14.
Joseph now to kick this one away. Taken at the goal line. And a penalty marker's down on the field. And they might be backing up a bit here to start the drive. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. They'll set up to throw. That one complete to Horsted. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
It's vitally important to wrap him up immediately because if you let that big guy get a head of steam up, boy, then you've got real trouble trying to get him down.
But they're able to hold him to a short gain on first down. 6 yards left on second down. And flags come in as he gets forward for about 3 yards. Now let's check on the call.
Holding offense.
You can see this quite a bit on running plays with the guys out wide. A lot of times, though, it doesn't get caught.
You're exactly right, because it's away from the play usually, so a lot of it goes undetected. But I know this will surprise you. I coach some receivers in the offseason. We work a lot on hand placement and blocking downfield. Might want to take that course.
They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. Now a handoff to Richard. And he'll get this one up to about his 14. Give him 2 yards that time, and it's going to leave him with a third and 11 situation. Back to throw. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. And he will not get what he needed as he stops short of the first down at around the 22. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And that'll bring up fourth down.
A short gain that doesn't get him the first down brings up a fourth down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it. Fourth down, A.J. Cole comes on to punt. Fielded just inside the 30. A good kick that time, but also a pretty good 15-yard return. And the Vikings will take over here, first and 10. The Vikings taking the field here for their second drive of the game. And last time, able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6. They start the drive with Cook. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. Second and 6.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
From just shy of midfield, Cousins. That ball nearly intercepted. The rookie had his hands on it, but couldn't pull it in.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense that that fell harmlessly to the ground. On third down, Cousins. He's going to get this one down to Cook, and he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
It's a nice job hitting him on the angle route there. Coming out of the backfield, cutting sharply across the middle. And that's good timing between the quarterback and his receiver.
Effective third down play to move the chains. To play in this first half, 7-3, our score. We remind you in just a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Orlando and our good friend Jonathan Coachman. Coach will run through some of the numbers and the next-gen stats from this first half of football. So, and this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Matthias Farley. And the Raiders are going to have it here at their own 32-yard line.
Well, this had trouble written all over from the start. He's got two extra defensive backs in the game he's got to deal with. They're in a dime set. So everywhere he's looking, he's seeing a different color jersey. And sure enough, this one winds up being intercepted.
Here's Las Vegas ready to take the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Over the middle, complete. It's Adams. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes and they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect. First down, he'll drop to throw. And Waller taking it in over the middle. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Again, he'll drop to throw. It's a screen to Richard. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. He'll look to throw again.
Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete.
This will be a gain of about 8 to the 27-yard line. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him the football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit, but get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are, you know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
He'll find Richard here underneath.
And yeah, brought down, but not before he was able to break the tackle, and the extra effort moves the sticks. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get 3 before halftime. From the right hash, this from an even 40 yards out. The kick by Carlson is good. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. So the turnover leads to points as they add 3 there.
Yeah, what a sequence there and a nice one for them. They force the interception, put together a little drive, and then come away with 3 points. Nothing to it, partner. Just do it.
Time for one play on offense. 7 seconds to go in the half as the kick is away. Takes it at the 7. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Flag coming out as they line up to kneel on it. He'll take the knee and the final couple seconds will tick by in this first half. So we have reached halftime here in Vegas with the Raiders on top. As we send you to our EA studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, right, Brandon. Thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to this slimmed-down version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This game's had a little bit of everything thus far and certainly plenty to look forward to as the teams are right back out there for the second half. So we'll get right back out there as well, as we'll turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
Vikings set to receive the second half kickoff, and they trail it here as we resume play. Taken in at the 3. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. And the Vikings set to go on offense to begin the third quarter. And they do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for them, because is it going to win the game? No, but you have to do something to bring some life to your sideline.
Cousins and the Vikings with a 1st and 10 right at the 30. He'll start by handing it off to Dalvin Cook. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and six.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Throwing is Cousins. That's caught by the tight end, Irv Smith Jr.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the ball, as we just saw there.
First down, here's the run with Cook. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so.
Now that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've kind of hit the jackpot there.
And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Cousins gives way to Cook. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
Hey, when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
Ahead of the chains now, second and 2. Here's Cousins. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
It's easy to see when we review this that the ball needs to come out quicker because if you don't throw it right on the break, you bring a crowd of people into the equation.
And that's why it got knocked away there. After the incompletion, here now, third and 2. Cousins to throw it. Open man is Thielen. It's complete. And he will have a Vikings first down, and he's going to have it by plenty. Able to get 8 yards there on third and 2.
I don't care how many times we see it. I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
They go play action. Cousins. And complete right side to Cook. And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short. To throw is Cousins. Smith catches left side.
How about the timing on that one? Boy, they were in sync, weren't they? Three-step drop, balls out of his hands, right to the tight end. Nice completion, just like they do it in practice.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. To the air again, it's Cousins. Goes right back to Smith again. Yeah, this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now it brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. Second and 1 from the 2. Left side, Cook. And this is not going to do it as he stopped at the 2-yard line. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball.
And he will score! Touchdown, Vikings! C.J. Ham taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Vikings are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And that's why you have the fullback, Charles. Couldn't get it in the play before with a smaller guy. Turn to a little more power. They score it.
And that has to warm the hearts of a lot of old-school football fans. They love when they get to see a little bit of power football.
Greg Joseph on for the extra point. And he'll put it through, and that evens us up at 10 apiece. So that drive, 12 plays in length, and it's culminated by a 2-yard touchdown run. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. Johnson now returning. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line. So here comes the Raiders offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. Their halftime lead now evaporated. We're back to level following that touchdown a moment ago.
And that shouldn't change the mindset a whole lot from an offensive perspective, because they already knew this was going to be a hard-fought game. Now they just need to go out, execute their game plan, and keep moving.
They'll run on first down. Walter. And not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24.
Definitely too early to panic, but that is his 4th carry of the game, and collectively has a total 10 yards. So maybe there's no panic, but maybe some concern.
Yeah, and maybe a little concern up front because they're not giving him any space right now. The run only got a yard. Here's 2nd and 9. Now back to throw. And that throw behind his man, he missed him, incomplete.
Well, this at least is the right idea. I think they've got to get the tight end more involved.
He had just 1 target in the first half, incomplete. Now incomplete here with the 1st target of the second half.
Yeah, should not stop them at all from going back to him, though. Find him, find him.
After an incomplete pass on 2nd down, that'll leave him trying to convert on 3rd and 9. He'll drop to throw. That's complete to Richard, the running back. And boy, he is very close to a 1st down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And that's going to bring up a 4th down.
That pattern and scheme was well defensed on 3rd down. He tried to just sprint from one side of the field to the other, and they got it to him quickly. But no chance at yards after the catch there, and they stop him short.
The
before they can get the punt away whistles as we've come to the end of the third quarter of action. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Here's A.J. Cole now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. So possession goes over here on the punt. Minnesota now ready for their next possession. Excellent job by their defense to force the punt and provide them with this opportunity, all tied in the fourth quarter. And the Vikings with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And that is incomplete.
This has certainly been a physical game so far. Limited scoring opportunities for both sides. And there's another chance that goes unfulfilled.
Here they go again, second and 10 from the 25. Handoff comes to Cook, and he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
I think sometimes when you're trying to get after the quarterback, maybe it's better to be lucky than great, because I think on that one, he's just trying to get upfield and rush the passer. Instead, the tackle for the loss landed right in his lap.
The Vikings on third down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. This is third and 11. Throwing, Cousins. And that's complete to K.J. Osborne. And he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now Cousins. Complete. Smith has it. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40.
That was a nice throw out there to the flat, but they defended that pretty well. The hope is to go ahead and put it on him so he can turn and get upfield and gain additional yardage. There just wasn't anywhere to go on that play.
Working with a second and 4. Draw play, Cousins to Cook. And tackled down after a gain of 3. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down. The Vikings on third down. They've been near perfect, 4 for 5 to this point. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. They run it again with Cook. And able to pick up the first across midfield to the 47. 45 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
Brandon, unfortunately, I've been here before. They've had 2 opportunities to stop them, so this is demoralizing. They haven't gotten it done. Now you're calling all your blitzes, all your attack defenses, but you're not worried about playing your normal position. You're going to take chances now.
Well, you said it. 2 third down opportunities to get off the field. Couldn't do it, and the clock continues to roll. So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 47. Now Cousins. That's complete to the receiver, Thielen. And he just falls short down at the 1 yard line. A big play there, Cousins to Thielen, 46 yards.
We always talk about the guy who paid off the play, don't we? The guy who caught it or ran it. But how about the elements that go into making a big play? This one in particular, able to scan the field. Pocket held up nicely. What a terrific job by the offensive line. The route well run, and the football right on the money.
A field goal could get him the lead, but it might not be enough here as they come up on first and goal. Trying the power game with Ham. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. C.J. Ham, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Vikings have taken the lead. Well, fullback touchdowns have become rare. We just saw two of them by the same guy here.
And if you had him on your fantasy team, I'm hanging out with you now for stock tips.
Joseph now to have the PAT. He's got it as they go up by a total of 17 to 10. So that one, an 8-play drive. It spans 75 yards. And it ends with a 1-yard touchdown run. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. Out of the end zone comes Johnson. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. Now the Vegas offense heading back out there. And now they'll look to answer working from behind. And remember, this offense has sputtered, yet to score here in the second half. They'll need to change that here. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Got an open man, Keelan Cole. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. Second and 2. They'll find his running back here, Richard. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line.
That was a pretty favorable situation there. What would you call that, second and manageable? Smart play, too. Didn't force it downfield when he didn't have it. Just checked it down, let him get the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football, and the Vikings pick up the football. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. On first down, Cook. They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of four. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Again, it's Cook. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Here's Cook. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. Now the Raiders going to burn their third and final timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. And they will take a knee here. From back at the four, here's second and goal. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. This will be a loss of three and now a much tougher third down looming.
And this is where the mental part of the game comes into play. Defense is out of timeouts. Just hold on to the football. No sense really trying to score. They should be able to run this one out.
Tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. Cousins just going to take this one down to a knee and end it.
Yeah, it's fun to kneel down in front of your home crowd, but when you go on the road, that band of brothers attitude, right, just us against the world and get it done, how happy are they?
I remember a coach at a previous stop telling me, you get a win on the road, doesn't matter the opponent, get out of there like you stole something. And they did in this one. So the final seconds have ticked away in this Minnesota victory. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we say so long from Las Vegas.